Honorable Lieutenant Governor, respected Chief Secretary, DGP Madam, Senior Secretaries, Heads of Departments, leaders from the community, representatives of civil society, welcome you all for this beautiful evening. Just a few minutes back, we had a team of guests from US. They came here to see what Raj Nivas is doing, also to participate in some social activity, social work among a well-meaning NGO here who is doing commendable work among the children who are intellectually incapacitated. Friends, today we are going to have the 9th lecture of this leadership lecture program, and this lecture is going to be given by Dr. S. Kanagasabai. All the heads of departments who are here, and of course many of the secretaries also, must be knowing Dr. S. Kanagasabai. He was a senior officer who worked in the various capacities, basically in planning and research, economic and statistics. Also, he worked on deputation in other organizations like Housing Board, PIBDIC, Distillery, etc. Dr. Kanagasabai is an economist. He got doctorate in economics, and during his tenure, the Sudhandra Punvila Nagar, which has been established by Housing Board, which has accommodated 77 MIG flats through an advanced contribution method, was started. He is remembered for initiating steps towards zero budgeting. He gave a lot of training those days for zero budgeting, which is relevant even today. And in his credit, to his credit, he has brought out a lot of publications relating to Puducherry on survey on small scale industries, the status of power supply to industries, local area development scheme, etc. Now, today he is going to make a small presentation on Puducherry Vision 2030. In fact, Dr. Kanagasabai was also involved in preparing two important documents. One was prepared in sometime back, Vision 2020 by Pondicherry government. Also, he was involved in preparing Puducherry Development Report by Planning Commission. He was also actively involved in preparing those reports. So as I can recall, Honorable Lieutenant Governor, in the lastly held planning board meeting, requested the government and government departments to bring out a vision document 2030 to make a layout, to make a roadmap for Pondicherry to progress. So therefore, this presentation will be of much use to enlighten all of us about where we are and how we can go. It's an insider view, since Mr. Dr. Kanagasabai was in government service for more than 34 years and retired about 5 years back. So more or less, it is he's having a contemporary vision, the inside vision of Pondicherry. So let us welcome Dr. Kanagasabai, and we request you, Dr. Kanabe sir, please come. You can deliver lecture. Thank you.
Good evening, all of you. I am immensely thankful to Honorable Lieutenant Governor for having given me an opportunity to stand before this August gathering under the leadership series. This is definitely a day to be remembered by me. the secretary to Lieutenant Governor has also given a lot about me on his introductory speech. I am much thankful to him. So I am thankful to the Chief Secretary, Development Commissioner, Finance Secretary, DGP, and other heads of departments, public from various walks of life, community leaders. Thank you, one and all. The Vision Puducherry we thought we require a vision, just like for household management, how to manage our finance, we require it for a state or a union territory, whatever the entity. Definitely, what type of vision we are going to have in the days to come. Previously, we had a vision document for 20 years that was prepared by the Madras School of Economics. At that time, I was coordinating that activity as a director of statistics and partly as a secretary housing board. Then, that was for 20 years. That was a very good reference document. They have gone into all the details and they prepared a very good document. Something have been implemented, many things remain unimplemented. Thereafter, as a part of the 50th year of planning exercise, the state development report has been prepared for each state and the union territory as a part of the centrally sponsored schemes, and accordingly the planning commission have brought out in 2010 a Puducherry development report, a nice report with all the developmental particulars. But based on these two things, we have the required data, but of course, there is some sort of a gestation period, time gap is there. All the data were collected in 2000 to 2003, 2004. So there is some sort of a gap of 15 years. And also a lot of things have also changed in the Union Territory of Puducherry since then. We have gone into the public account and the central grant ratio between the loan and the grant ratio have changed, and financially, as far as we can say, we are a fragile economy. So how best we could be able to utilize the limited finance to bring more activities, mostly of development in nature. Also, the borrowed funds, instead of making it use for revenue account, revenue head, we have to go in for at least partly for the capital infrastructure. We are totally handicapped with infrastructural facilities in the Union Territory of Puducherry. As far as this, we have boulevard, roads, but congested traffic, so many other things. Then on the one hand, we have a lot of tourism potential. On the other hand, we don't have much movable space. How the tourist will come? The pavement dwellers are there. So some sort of a trade-off need to be made, bringing some sort of a sober development by way of having a good vision, a visionary. Since our means are limited, as in economics, means are limited, our wants are unlimited. So our finance is very limited. We have plenty of works to be done. How to go about it? How we will go? So this trade-off needs some sort of a vision. So accordingly, we have brought in the vision document. Some sort of a vision document based on the strength, weaknesses, and what are the strengths the Puducherry economy has. How we will take advantage of the strength, how we will try to reduce the weaknesses, then we have given some suggestions how to go about it. We have an annual growth rate of 10% and more. Even in all India basis, normally we are always trying to go in for around 7 to 8%, sometimes 6.5, 7.5, 8 like that. The small, beautiful Union Territory of Puducherry has about 10% of the annual growth at an average rate, sometimes 11, 12, sometimes 9. And also, we have a high per capita income of around 1.74 lakhs. This is based on the Directorate of Economics and Statistics estimates, quick estimates of 2016-17. We all know pretty well, the per capita income is worked out, the net income, state income, divided by the population projected in the particular point of time. So based on that, our per capita income, it gives some sort of an approximation to the standard of living. Each person will approximately have 1.74 lakh per annum, which means at least 15,000 rupees each person has per month. It is not that everybody will have 1.74. It is an approximation. Though our small union territory, suppose even a small modest increase of some sort of a flow of capital would definitely enhance our GSDP, the gross trade domestic product, which is otherwise known as gross trade value added. So that is the, actually in the GSVA is nothing but whatever the state income plus the taxes added minus the subsidy given, that is the GSVA. So, being a small economy, the UT can replicate new initiatives. A lot of initiatives we have. Probably, we are the first union territory, even we can say that the financial inclusion in the banking front, we have done that. Then, the DPT, Direct Benefit Transfer Scheme, we have attempted. Then, even for the petrol day-to-day, petrol diesel rate, day-to-day variation also, one of the union territory ours. So any new initiatives we can bring in and replicate, so there is no stumbling block here. We have a very good coastal line of about 45 kilometers. Lot of potential is there for the marine products, but we have not tapped it. But in fact, very many details of the fish production shown here does not actually reflect the real thing. Many of the things that is being done near Pudukkottai, Jagadapattinam is getting included. Many of the catches brought here, it is unaccounted in Puducherry. That needs to be done. And also the marine products, how best we could be able to develop it. Even in the earlier vision document of the Madras School of Economics, they have stated that sea processing industries without causing any pollution or marine product, how best we can able to go. We have to tap that. Then we have lot of education institution, health indicators. Our health indicators, whether you take infant mortality rate or the birth rate per thousand or the death rate, very, very favorable. In the educational level also, as per 2011 census, we have around 85.85% of the literacy rate. By now, we could have achieved furthermore also. We can say the Puducherry is a knowledge hub. We have lot of the universities, the very many people from the different states, they used to come to Puducherry for study purposes. And abundant natural tourism potential we have. The tourism potential need to be worked out properly to raise the revenue resources for the Union Territory. And the French language or the French aura, their fashion, then French cuisine, and these are all added strength. How best we could be able to go for. Even the learning of French language itself is an asset. But unfortunately, many of the people, they don't go in for French learning because
what type of things, employment avenue I will have, except this giving tuition or going to some colleges, something like that they have in their mind. Then this intensive network of commercial banks, because we have 271 commercial banks in this union territory, commercial banks plus the cooperative banks, regional rural banks. Our population as per 2011 census is 12.48, by this time it is around 14 lakh, something like that. So if it is the thing, it is less than 5,000 population per bank branch. If you go to other states, it be more than 9,000, 10,000, 12,000 like that. So very intensive banking network. That is why the financial inclusion is possible. Then easy accessibility to government officials. Any grievances, they can be easily the immediate senior officers at the chief secretary level or at the level of the council of ministers or at the honorable lieutenant governor level. People can easily go and approach. This is definitely one of the strengths. So we have all along have seen the strength, but we have our own weaknesses also. Because the as per the village land records, we have about 45,000 hectares of land. But out of which, we have only 30% available for agriculture purpose, 30.85%. It is around one single crop season. It is only for about 15,000 hectares. So if it is a double crop, more than once, it will be around 25,000 hectares. So what happened to the remaining hectares? It has gone to the business establishment. It has gone to these residential. It has gone to the cultural waste, fallow land, something like that. So whatever to feed to the increasing urban population and migration of the population, the limited land availability agriculture has to raise some productivity, thereby giving more employment opportunities for the labor force in the rural area itself. So they should not, there is heavy in the exodus of population from the rural to the urban. So which means the Puducherry is almost overcrowded. If you see that how many people from villages are coming and how many people they are not going back. They used to come here. After that, they will try to settle down here. That creates a lot of problem, not only for the health-related issues and these pollution-related issues and housing-related issues, all sort of issues come. So naturally, we have to give some sort of alternative avenue to the people who are willingly coming to the urban area. So that land availability, that limited land has to be utilized for different agricultural purposes. The groundwater, because everybody is aware, Prabhu Banerjee is also here, the water can, and because everybody is aware, that's why Honorable Lieutenant Governor is periodically giving importance, making field visits to go to various ponds, tanks, and taking that, because many of the things are disused. We may be knowing that during 1998-2005, there is an European Economic Commission that has come. They have allocated a lot of funds for just rehabilitating, renovating 84 tanks. These tanks were going well, but for the last 7 to 8 years, the association is defunct, the Tank Users Association, and except a few tanks, many of the tanks totally disused and encroachment is there. No desilting have taken place. That is creating a havoc, not only for the irrigation purpose, but also for the percolation of the groundwater, that is the water to the groundwater level has gone too deep. Previously, we used to go to the 200 feet, 300 feet, we used to get water. Now it is 500, 600 feet. Probably Mr. Radhakrishnan, he is a previous hydrologist, he may be knowing that. So how best we could be able to contain, arrest this deterioration. So likewise, there are more than 500 ponds. All the 84 tanks have connectivity to these 500 ponds. Many of the ponds are mostly encroached, disused. Recently, this Dan Foundation has also, in coordination with the HUL, they have taken up around 30 ponds. So in different places, they are taking deepening, they are just rehabilitating these works. And by way of people's participation, because at least 10 to 15% they have to provide as a margin money and open on a bank account, thereafter only the HUL will release the funds. So people's participation is a must, whether it is a tank maintenance or it is the maintenance of the ponds. Then this, we know that already explained the chaotic and congested traffic issues. So we may be knowing that we have more of vehicle population than of human population in Puducherry. Because everybody is having four cars, four or five vehicles like that. Now the cyclists are not at all cared. Pedestrians are totally disregarded. Then they don't have anything like, we don't expect anything like in the European countries, a separate line for the cyclist and the pedestrians. At least the human life should be valued. That is not here. Even people themselves are not aware. They don't care about, they can crisscross the road anyway as they like. It needs some sort of an improvement. Then I have just mentioned the flyovers. Puducherry may not have much flyovers, they don't have space, at least to the limited extent. The road network without the occupants of these platform dwellers, that we require something. And also the inadequate public transport. This is causing havoc. The people, we may be boasting that, okay, Puducherry, we have small union territory, we are clearing everything at one stroke. Abid Hussain, the then Planning Commission, once commented about 10 years back, where is the single window in Pondicherry? You are adding one more window. Which means, we never have a proper single window clearance, because there are multiple windows. Each department doesn't want to dispense with their practice. Just they want to keep their, so many things. It is the industries, it is the agriculture, it is the electricity, then it is the town and country planning, or the fire service, because it has to be a time bound. We have an industrial policy, we have a proper guidelines, but many of the guidelines are not followed. Even in the vision document they have indicated, at the time itself, many of the industrials are afraid to come to Pondicherry because of the existing multiple windows drive away the potential investors from the scene. This is one problem, we have to address it. In the 98 to 2007-5, almost we have 50% of the state domestic product comes from secondary sectors, that is manufacturing and others, construction. But now only the services sector is leading. Why? Because many of the industries are closed. They are all fly-by-night operators. They come and go with getting some concession. But now the concession, the power subsidy, central investment subsidy is also partly withdrawn. Then they have a problem. And at the same time, added to their woes, because this multiplicity of windows that is causing havoc, nobody is willing to come. And also even in the industries, the militant trade unions, this some sort of a multiple unions, they just threaten the people. That kind of sort of atmosphere is there in some of the major industries. That is also causing havoc. This previously in the, well, the previous vision document by the Madras Club, they have complaining, many of the people are complaining, the inordinate delay in providing powers, even after the sanctions. But now some improvement have taken place, I am told. I don't know how far it is effective. The migration of population from other states. For example, particularly Yenam region, 40%, 50%, one decennial growth, if you take from 81 to 91, 45% decennial growth. Then 91 to 2001, 70%, like that. How? Because of the migration. Migration from maybe a neighboring Andhra Pradesh and other things. Because such kind of migration brings a lot of pressure upon us. We have to issue ration card, we have to provide a lot of benefits. That causes some sort of a problem for our fragile financial resources. So it has to be, because normal decennial growth should not go beyond 2 to 2.5 per annum, the population growth. But when Mr. Sundaresan was also the administrator, I hope, at the time itself he has noticed about, he told me when I was in planning. So this much percentage has taken place like this in Yenam. Because it is not that the population has grown in Yenam or some other places all on a sudden. Because the population comes from other states, that should be restricted, because otherwise the financial implication will be heavy upon us. And this lack of environmental awareness and solid waste management, Honorable Lieutenant Governor is taking a lot of initiatives, and this under the Swachh Bharat and so many other things. But despite that, there are some problems except the Puducherry municipality. The biodegradable, non-biodegradable waste at the segregation point, it takes place, I hope, in Puducherry, but I don't know about the other parts of the Puducherry. At the segregation place, it takes place or not, this is one thing. The inadequate housing, because the town and country planning, I had some discussion with them. They told that the under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, they have this beneficiary-led construction and other three or other vertical components are there. In that, they have called for some application, out of which 69,000 application had come over. At least to avoid some sort of duplication, even if it is admitted, around 35,000 is still genuine. This 35,000, they have targeted to complete it by 2020-22. So what the point is, the inadequate housing, not mainly due to this, because the population of this urban, because of the influx of the population. Yenam is urban, Mahe is urban, Puducherry is almost urban, except part of the Karaikal. Otherwise, because the inadequate housing, the lot of pressure are there. Then loss making PSUs, because this is one area. In Tamil Nadu, there is some sort of a Raghavan committee. They have worked out long back, around 7 or 8 years back, they have suggested certain things. You have to, it is not that many people are, because their livelihood need to be protected. At the same time, these are all white elephants. How long this can be, this can keep on going on? Because you have to keep on funding these loss making units by way of dispensing standard resources from the plan or non-plan, whatever the head, to those units which are incurring huge loss, except certain units like PIPDIC or distilleries and the power corporation. Many of the units, loss making units, are there. So it is a huge burden upon the exchequer. A decision needs to be taken upon this. This is the decadal population growth rate. Why I have put it, you just 29.23 is the 10-year growth. This is projected. 2021 since we have projected based on the past. This is also done by Directorate of Economics and Statistics. This is 29.23% for Puducherry. Maybe 2 or 3%, maybe lesser or maybe more. Then Karaikal 17.23, it is not that Karaikal, a real just a reduction has taken place. My hunch is many of the people who have come to Puducherry or who are coming to Puducherry, getting added in Puducherry rather than and getting reduced in Karaikal. Mahe definitely goes well with the Kerala pattern. Then Yenam is one serious issue need to be pondered over. We have to do certain things, because the percentage, that is what I told, at least each family should have minimum 10 to 12 children. Otherwise, this kind of increase is nowhere else, nowhere in India, nowhere in any country in the world. 77, 54, 45%, nothing, nowhere in the world. Yes, sir, this is actually, sir, this in 54.67% is the actual 2011 census, sir. That is 74.51 in 1991, 54.67 in 2000, 40.28% in 1981. So it goes 40, 50, 70 like that. So now that we have made a projection of 70% based on the last decennial growth, But it might have maybe hovering around 50 to 60. This is, we have just the predominantly urban in nature calling for urban-centric policies that we have to evolve. The rural-centric policies means we cannot go in for increase in the agricultural productivity, keep on going, because the some sort of a precision farming only we can do, or the drip irrigation by way of economizing the water usage. But we need an organic farming for value added. And also, then intensive cropping we require, because when I joined here in 1978, at that time, agriculture department was planning to bring 120,000 metric tons of rice production. They never crossed beyond 70,000 metric tons. Now it is around 55,000 metric tons. So that means the other sources from Tamil Nadu or Andhra Pradesh only, the rice just supply is met for the demand of the people. So we require some sort of agriculture, intensive agriculture, by way of we have to increase the productivity by reducing the usage of water also. Also the organic farming that has suggested, even in the Madras School of Economics they have suggested, because that is the value added. Now and then some people are also doing it in Kodapakam area and other things in Puducherry. That is giving good value. Now people are also aware now, the organic farming, how much value added, that brings more thing to them. This is also one, the inter-region and intra-region exodus from rural to urban stemmed through skill development. Specific area-based agriculture framework for Puducherry and Karaikal region, because these are the two regions we can go in for agriculture activities, that also mostly for Karaikal, partly for Puducherry. This is the thing, the net state income, we have already explained that. The percentage is the primary sector, agriculture, forestry, fisheries, everything. This is 6.84 only. It is out of 25,097 crores, 1,470 crores alone comes from agriculture and allied activities, including fisheries, animal husbandry, dairy, everywhere. The secondary sector is real product manufacturing and the construction activity, that comes around 40%. Then 54% comes from the services sector like real estate, tourism, banking, insurance, all these things. Total. This is the tax on product, we have to add it, subsidies on product, we have to subtract it, then it comes state income. This is the vision suggestions, just based on the Puducherry development report, based on the previous vision, some of the points, and some of the points I myself have given it, all these things added, this is given for a thought. This already we have explained, this is also. Marine products processing industries, the Department of Agriculture and Industries need to take initiative in encouraging agro-based industries in few centralized rural and urban pockets by providing required facilities and incentives. Presently, the local milk production, we have around 1 lakh liters of milk production every day we consume in Puducherry. But unfortunately, we could be able to meet only 40,000. Sometimes lean season 25,000. The remaining things we are getting only from neighboring state of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Either at the normal price of what we are giving, or at the seasonal demand, we have to give extra more. But here we have to encourage the, just by way of giving small and marginal farmers some milch animals by farming SHEs and through bank loans. But the only impediment here is we don't have much arable area, and we don't have much about these. We should go in for a certain particular area for fodder cultivation. If we go for that and we try to do that, their income will slightly go up and their migration also likely to be arrested. So that when they are given some sort of adequate employment avenue, raising some income, people will think of staying in the village itself. the same engine of growth is secondary and the tertiary sector. This needs some sort of a further proactive measures are required. As far as my request to this August house is that at least we should go in for more of productive oriented, small industrial oriented products rather than services activities. In the longer run, the industry product, manufacturing product alone will increase the employment avenue and the state GDP. Over a period of time, we should have minimum of 50 to 60% that should come from manufacturing sector. But presently, the trend is not in favor of secondary, that is the manufacturing sector. The single window clearance, already we have discussed. The one more crucial issue I have brought in, this is an issue, I think this is in the some sort of arbitration I am told. The ideal land parcel of 800 acres in Saidarapattan Karasur need to be put into use in consultation with Ministry of Home Affairs and the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, because the major area, because we have lot of land resources remaining idle that needs to be put into use. Even though we have a knowledge hub, we have a lot of employed manpower, all facilities, unfortunately, many of our graduates don't have spoken skill and they don't have the technical skills. They may be IT graduates, they may be graduates from the very good engineering colleges, but their employability, their skills need to be tapped and upgraded. That has to be upgraded. They have to be given some sort of a training to upgrade their skills so that they could be ably employed here or elsewhere. So IT enabled services are doing well, so it needs further thrust. The tourism potential we have already discussed. The investors meet, I think there is some sort of a WTO cell in the industries department, but I don't think it is very active. There is one cell that has been opened, WTO cell, that needs some sort of activation. The commercial banks and industries functioning in the UT of Puducherry may be tapped under CSR initiative to take up desilting and renovation of tanks and ponds. Instead of we ourselves are allocating funds, better by way of participatory approach, that some sort of association for the tanks and the ponds need to be formed, and the banks may be tapped because they have corporate social responsibility, some 2% allocation. So in the Puducherry, whatever the credit they mobilize, they are not deploying all the credit, because there is always a lacuna between the credit deposit ratio. Because previously in those days, when I was just looking after the banking matter in the planning department, at the time people used to say the credit deposit ratio is 40%, 45% as per the Reserve Bank of India bulletin when we see. But when the state level bankers committee background materials they circulate, they say 70, 72, 75 like that. They put all the investment also, because they simply say, because our corporate office, your people are directly getting loan and we are not giving the loan. But there is a lot of complaint in those days at that particular point of time, whatever the amount you mobilize, that is being siphoned off to be utilized in some other states. So this kind of dichotomy is there. So we can definitely give some sort of an instruction or advice or request to the commercial banks. I think the lead bank, Indian Bank, so they can be just requested or asked to go in for some CSR initiative for just taking up the pond related works, because this is one crucial issue, or the tank related works. So we have already discussed about the lieutenant governors, because the use of Velrambattieri, Kanaganeri only I have pointed out, not all the things, because this is one example where how a people friendly administrator could be able to do certain things. So that kind of things, we at the same time the local people need to be just involved in the entire process. Otherwise, the sustainability will not be there. That is more important. This is a comprehensive welfare oriented policy is required, because we are addressing all people for all benefits, irrespective of their status, economic status. We have to go in for only the really targeted groups. BPL means real BPL. As per the planning commission's latest, at the time it is only 90,000 in those days. maybe slightly increased, but now the BPL, it is at more than around 1.5 to 2 lakhs. So the entire benefit is siphoned off. So how best we could be able to go in for? So, and also each public oriented department need to be requested just to prepare some sort of a vision document like health, education, and the revenue. So how best we they are people friendly, how best they are going for the over the next 10 years, so that could be integrated once we prepare a vision 2030. Here the plan finance, this is a very crucial issue. Any new plan scheme generate 3 major liabilities: the interest payment on borrowed funds, market borrowing, and negotiated loan through HUDCO or the NABARD and other things, the interest payment on borrowed funds. I think in the 2017 onwards, the interest and the principal we have been paying, that will be regular phenomena that is causing havoc. Almost 20 to 25% of our budget resources will go towards principal payment as well as the interest payment. Then maintenance of assets created during the plan period. Because the once we create an asset, we simply leave it as it is. We go for new assets. What about the old assets? That has to be maintained. Then salaries of personnel employed in plan scheme who remain in government employment even after the plan scheme, which means we have to be very careful in recruiting people. So that is the only thing, because the the zero-based budgeting exercise need to be done once in 3 years. This is my suggestion, because twice we have attempted that. In 2010, it was around 500 scheme. At the time, Mr. Chandramogan sir, who was the chief secretary, who advised me to go in for this, and we have done a real exercise. In that, we could be able to reduce the number of schemes along with certain components also to the 300. Whether that is in force or not, we have to ask the present director planning, Mr. Shantamurthy, only how best it is effective. The government of Puducherry should look at its expenditure pattern closely and see that individual-oriented benefit flow only to the eligible target groups, eliminating ineligible. A contour is given above for preparing an implementable Puducherry vision, some sort of contour over the next 10 years, and each major and minor sector tapping potential with proactive policy framework to be initiated to achieve inclusive growth with balanced regional development. That is what I am finishing, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kanagasabai, for giving us a brief of the status of economy, or where the Pondicherry is now located. And you also given a way forward, an idea of how to go about. So now I think Dr. Kanagasabai will take some questions also. If questions are there, you can feel free to ask him.
Sir, there was a 2020 plan. What happened to it, and where are we on that? Because we are still in 2018.
Yes, in the introduction itself, I have told that the 2020 plan is still in existence, but some of the things, as a reference document, some departments have used it. And why the 2020 document is definitely a reference document that cannot be sustained because of the time gap and the lot of data gap. And now the problem is lot of issues have much water has flown under the surface. That is what because at that particular point of time when the plan was prepared, the UT was having a very good central assistance of more than 70%. And only our resources is 25 to 30%. But all the things have changed, the scenario has changed. So it is not that the document should be dumped. It is that I have told already, the document, certain points, still I referred it. The document is very useful, but partly academic exercise, partly implementable. But now we have crossed almost 18 years. Still 1 or 1.5 years, 2 years is there. So a lot of changes have taken place, the public accounts
and the grant pattern and other things have changed, so many other issues. So I think a fresh document, preferably a 10-year span may be a good thing, rather than going in for 20 years document. That is why I thought it fit to bring it.
What are the solutions for the problems that are created by immigration? You give whopping figures of 50, 70, 80%.
No, that is only for in a particular region, not in anywhere. But some sort of a migration always takes place between state to state. Even in Tamil Nadu also that kind of things takes place. But I am saying we don't have much resources. We have only limited resources. And how best we could be able to, we cannot just concentrate on a particular region wherein lot of influx of population migration is there. So I cannot give solution, but only thing my, as far as my knowledge goes, I can able to say something like arrest the trend first. That is the one thing. How best it could able, because 40%, 50%, 60% means whether our own population will never increase like that. So everybody is aware of the family, how to maintain a family, they will not go beyond 2 to 3 children. So people are very careful, but it is not that instead of 1,000 families, if another 1,000 family comes from outside, that needs to be tackled.
Hello, Dr. Saab, you have given a very elaborative vision of 2030. But I think one point I think is missing, that is about coastal transport. We are having a sea all around, but we are unable to go to Puducherry in a ship as we do in Andaman Nicobar Islands or to Andaman or to Australia even. It is all connected by this. What is the future of this coastal transport in the coming years?
Yes, sir. That is what I have already told, sir. Even though I have not explicitly mentioned that, implicitly we have a coastal, we have to take advantage, and also we have the tourism potential. Because once you go for that part of the tourism, that needs to be, even even in this vision document, we have just amplified those things also. But that point explicitly I have not mentioned. It is part of the tourism development, sir.
Sir, there are two fields which are indirectly related to health. One is non-polluting industry. Could you tell us more about how we could bring in IT sector, which is non-polluting? Second thing is, we have read and listening and hearing news about that how pesticides increase the number of cancers in the patients. So how well we can do implement organic farming in Puducherry? Can I elaborate on these two fields?
No, this is the organic farming means the natural farming. It is the by way of compost pits or the green leaves. That is the organic farming. Don't put any pesticides and increase the productivity. That is not the, so that is a health hazard. So that is what we saw. Why people should, because we should have a specific things, unique thing for Puducherry. That unique thing should be in the form of an organic thing. It is a value added, but productivity definitely lesser than what normal practice we are getting it. That needs to be tapped, sir. These are all suggestions, sir. Actually, all on a sudden, nothing would take place. We have to think, we have to ponder over. After that only we can. So this organic farming, even in 2012, we have formed a working group with the then Development Commissioner Raj Nivas. He was the chairman, I was the member secretary, wherein we have co-opted one the retired dean of Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, Mr. Samantham, and the fisheries expert, Mr. Balasubramaniam from the Chidambaram Annamalai University near Parangipet. We have co-opted, we have given suggestion in the 2012 itself in bringing all these things. But unfortunately, many things have not moved. We have communicated and we have circulated all the things to the department concerned also. But it is the concerned department they have to, because the planning department is only a suggestive or advisory thing. It cannot implement. But once you implement it, we can monitor it by way of evaluation. That is the only thing we can do. But as far as your question is concerned, this is organic farming. Definitely it will bring. We are not going for pesticides. Organic farming is no pesticides at all.
Yes, just a small kind of observation. The presentation, this Vision 2030, about your perception about the Puducherry Vision to 2030, it doesn't has any mention about the United Nations Millennial Sustainable Goals. Because as far as my knowledge goes, you know, we keep it as a backdrop in formulation of all the policies or all the vision statements. But that is not finding its place somewhere. Any mention was not there.
No, this the millennium concept that goes with the all over India. So once you have some sort of a thing like that, only within that framework only we can do that. The millennium goals we have achieved already in Puducherry, because the millennium goals like the mortality rate and other things, so probably the director of health may just elucidate those things. But your point is correct. We have to dovetail the millennium growth means, millennium goals and other things. We will definitely, once we prepare a vision, we will look into that. That is a good suggestion, no doubt about it. But within the overall all India level framework only, that has to come.
Yes.
But these things, these whatever the things I have told, it is the UT specific.
Sir, what is your vision about liquor in Pondicherry? Maybe in 2030, whether it will be reducing liquor consumption, will be reducing, or you have any other vision to reduce liquor consumption rate in Pondicherry?
In the vision document, I never thought of, I thought of only as a resources. As far as resources, your point is correct. In Tamil, what is the things takes place? It goes well with, it is entrenched in the Union Territory of Puducherry as a part of the French culture. That only I can say.
One fourth of our budget allocation goes towards this borrowings and interest. What's your suggestion to reduce that?
What is that, sir?
Budget 25% about going towards the borrowing, market borrowing and interest. What's your suggestion to reduce this thing and how we can go about
the only next? Thing is the gradual, we have to look into these public sector undertakings, number one, and we have to raise the resources. Resources raising is limited. But in the non-tax revenue, we have to think of user charges, something like that. That is the only way. That cannot augment more revenue. But at the same time, it is one part. Gradually, we have to move. On the one hand, you have to slightly raise the resource. On the other hand, you have to drastically reduce your expenditure pattern to the unnecessary schemes, unnecessary the PSUs, which are white elephants. At the same time, I say that people are there. Livelihood is there. It is not all in a seven, just like that you can close it and go. But now thinking need is needed. How best we can able to, in a phase out, gradually next 5 years, what we are going to do, how best we can able to do that. So that is the only, that is the way forward. That is the thinking. We can't immediately say how best we could able to raise resources. Even then, now there is a lot of centrally sponsored schemes. And I think till 2012, we have been using only the plan expenditure alone, we will show. It is the plan expenditure. Now, even the centrally sponsored schemes expenditure is also shown as a plan. That also, now a revenue and capital head has come into existence now, from this year onwards. So that means, now totality has been taken place in the overall budget, where the thing is, useful things, it should be budgeted. It should go to that. Even not only that, even the employees, the pensioner like me, all people are getting these things. So the salaries, the pension benefits, everything will go more than 25% to 30%. Will it be, Gondraj? 30%. 25%. And the PSUs, almost how much? It may go? 650 crores have gone. What is the dividend? The dividend given by the only two departments, two agencies. One is the Pondicherry Distilleries, another is the Power Corporation. No dividend. Because once we give some sort of a share capital or any other amount, they have to pay back part. Nothing comes. Any other questions, please?
Sorry, I asked about two questions first. One was the IT sector, sir, which is a non-polluting center. which Puducherry can concentrate in, how well we can develop IT sector.
No, now it is IT sector, IT enabled services are going well. I am told that.
Students are going outside.
Naturally, because you have been producing so many graduates, how all people could be affected? They have to go outside also. Puducherry alone, they cannot be employed. Everybody is just clamoring for this, what type of job our own people, graduates, even postgraduate students are clamoring for CLR employees here in Puducherry. That trend you should reduce it. They should be encouraged to go out. You provide a good training, spoken language, definitely they will move out. But people are content. They don't want to go out of Puducherry. That is the problem. If no question is there, I am thankful to the Honorable Lieutenant Governor and other Chief Secretary, Development Commissioner, DGP, Finance Secretary and other senior officials, departments, community leaders and the public for the patience. Whatever the mistakes I have committed, I seek your apology. Whatever the things I have done, because the love for Puducherry, I have done it. Thank you.
Good evening, Honorable Lieutenant Governor, colleagues. Basically, Dr. Kanag has nearly covered all the areas of concern which we have also been debating, discussing. I think these are the thrust areas. These are the thrust areas. Some more thrust areas will be identified as departments discuss and debate on these issues. From the point of view of public, I think employment would have to be one of the focus areas. Education, we have certainly a good amount of colleges, institutions, but the quality is an area of concern. And once there is a good quality education at a school level, at a higher education level, naturally the employability improves. So wish list, and wish list is quite long. As Mr. Banerjee was pointing out that what happened to the previous document. So vision document, yes, but even more challenging would be to chart out a path in the document itself, even if it means less number of thrust areas, but try to chart out a path which can take us to that destination. It was a pleasure to listen to Dr. Sahab. I never met him. It was discovery for me. He is a storehouse of information. Such a long memory of what happened in, you know, a decade back and beyond, and what can happen now, what is going on, what are the areas of concern. So certainly he is a very, very good resource person. Thanks a lot.
Nature helps you to get what you look for. And it was a few months ago, we were looking for you. Person like you, and you happen to become that. Because in the planning document, we talked about that we officers owe it to Puducherry to leave a vision behind. And that's what put the thinking cap on Neeti's head. And without any hair, he could think straight, no blockade. And he thought of you. And that's how you came into the focus. We read your document. He produced evidence to say you're the right person. And the good news is that you were available and you were willing to shoulder the responsibility of coming up with the vision document. our vision is that before the end of the year, we could produce an interim report, interim document at least. Take it to next 10 years. If that can happen, it'll be wonderful. If we can do it sometime the first week of November, that would be ideal. Why I say first week of November is because our chief secretary completes 1 year of work here. So if we can link it with this 1 year, it makes it historical. His 1 year document. A vision for 2030, certainly. What I would like to think is that you have already identified department-wise where we could begin. And as he rightly said, we just need a department-wise checklist, a department-wise roadmap, and even begin with one point at a time. Industry could begin with one, agriculture could begin with one thrust, education could begin with one thrust. If you had about 10 thrusts, and it's not difficult, every department with one thrust, we will have 10, and it'll make all the difference. And automatically from one, we'll come to the second and the third. It could become incremental roadmap for this year and next year. So let's have a roadmap for 2018, 2019. At that then, when the finance secretary works on his budget, he could start factoring it in his budget, say, this is a part of the vision document. So I would think, give us a roadmap. We will be requesting you to offer your services on a full-time basis as a consultant. Therefore, my friends, he would be part of our consultancy team in the planning department. We would be requesting our secretary planning to give you a space in the planning department itself. That's what we'd worked out. And then you could start working with one department at a time from your department, helping them identify those few strategies, and we could then get going. So I would think this is the way we could begin. This is not going to be just a verbal transaction. It is going to go into action transaction. Like, for instance, how do we revive our tank associations? It's very vital. We've been struggling for it the last 2 years. We made a very small headway. I think the secretary PWD needs your support to understand what was the background and history behind it, and how can we bring it to full bloom. And there's a willingness about it. Every secretary, every head of the leader here is willing to drive the change and make a contribution. This is the new part of it. So why not build on it? There is a new enthusiasm. And therefore, I would say, once you start working with department turn by turn, and say, here are the two things you start working on, and we have an interim document to work on, we will be able to achieve before these model codes of conduct set in, so that we can then implement rather than innovate at that time, so that there's no new policy statement. Policy statements are made, we are only into implementation. So we have, therefore I said, end of the year should take us to the road journey, and we should be scootering around, and not buying a scooter, but scootering around, because buying will be closed by the code of conduct, but going on the road will not be. So I would think that is where we need to take. And even every department makes one contribution, we make 10 contributions, and that's quite a lot. So I would say thank you so much. We hope that you start working with us from yesterday, not today, yesterday. And therefore, take us forward. Let us realize this vision. We love this place. All of us who've come from outside love this place. We like the people, but I think they're too contented. We are keeping them shaking up. They're very contented. They're happy with what they have. We are the North Indians who keep shaking them up. But they say, ma'am, we're happy. We have free rice. We have widow pension. We have retirement pension. We have free medical aid. We have free school. And of course, we have got security. So it takes care. Therefore, they are not angry about change. We have to anger the change. But to be anger the change, you've got to be angry ourselves. So please give us a vision. Work with individual departments, agriculture, most of all. How do we get going with organic agriculture? We've got organic experts here. So I think, and the marine, I loved it. Fisheries not here. We need to work a lot on fisheries. And we still have time for tanks. We still have time because the northeast monsoon has not come. So we got August, September, October, 3 months to fill up our tanks. And we'll have enough water for years to come. Hydrologist sitting right on your right. So we can engage him, even though he's retired, but we could then co-opt him also, along with Manohar, who is his. So I would say, give us, start working. Our Secretary of Finance, Ms. Dr. Kandavalu, we've already discussed this matter. We've discussed it with our Chief Secretary that we will be requiring your services. Whatever formalities are required, we will take this forward, but we want you. Pondicherry needs you, and you'll be fulfilling our vision for the next 10 years ahead. Thank you very much.